Holy Spirit.
Congregations. I hear that. Ooh. Good morning. I'm George Sanchez. The Congregation of Zion Lutheran Church in downtown Hamilton, Ohio, welcomes our Facebook and radio audiences to our 10 o'clock worship service. Our services are also available on the zionhamilton.org website. If you are in need of a prayer or want to have our weekly service bulletin emailed to you, please contact our church office at 513-863-5774 or email us at zionlutheranoffice@gmail.com. Leading the service is Vicar Patty Eaton. Our music director is Bill Seal. Our lector is Sonia Smith. Now we begin with our prelude.
When it's time to present the candle, can I ask if you'd be sitting close to the front, right? If you walk with me, the candle, and you light it from the Christ candle, I will walk over and present it to Bobby, and I'll do the words.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Pastor John is going to be doing the announcements as he ambles into the church.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome this morning. We begin the stewardship emphasis today, so for the next 6 weeks, you will see the charcoal drawing of, pencil drawing of Zion on the cover, and in future weeks, it will say O Zion Peace there. And every week, there will be an insert to the bulletin. It will be in reference to the temple talk given on that particular Sunday. Sandy Sanders has the temple talk this morning, and there will be five more. We're gearing up for November 11th. On November 11th, there's a congregational dinner at 8:00. Immediately following the worship. Next Sunday, there are going to sign up to begin that, and we hope all will plan to attend on our commitment Sunday. So thank you to the stewardship committee that's been doing a lot of work. You'll see the goals. You should have received a letter this week, so I hope you have read that. You'll get a second letter later on with the brochure about O Zion Peace, and the good news is about a significant match restoration costs down the road. So stay tuned and stay in tune with the materials and the resources that are being provided, and mark your calendars now for that Sunday, November the 11th day. It's a very special day this morning. Bobby Zorno is baptized into the family of God. His family is back here this morning with us. So we celebrate with Bobby on that occasion. Just so you know how connections work, Bobby and Michael Chambers are on the same team together for baseball, right, Michael? Okay. And my wife was Bobby's kindergarten teacher here in Hamilton many, many years ago now. So there's that
Hallelujah. Sign-up sheets for Oktoberfest are in the Great Hall.
There are lots of sign-ups out there. Yes, Oktoberfest. Basil's is not here yet, but there are other sign-ups out in the narthex today. Any other announcements? Yes, Dave.
One of Hamilton's community leaders passed away. His name was Dave Verloo. He's been in a nursing home recently. But he was the spearhead behind the Oak Door Pantry for years and years. He was the kind of guy that if it was a small thing, he'd be there right helping you. Then if it was a big thing and needed money, he'd get it. He'd be a wonderful man and set on it.
Dave Verloo, correct?
Please stand.
Preparing our hearts to come to our Lord's table of grace today, we use the order for confession and forgiveness as it's printed in your bulletin. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. You may choose to use the kneelers at this time.
Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name.
Amen.
God, who is rich in mercy, loved us, even when we were dead in sin, and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith.
Amen.
As we stand to sing, we'll sing just one verse of O Zion Haste. Progressively through the season of stewardship, we'll add a verse each Sunday, so we'll be singing. There's more than three that are in Evangelical Lutheran worship. We'll be adding those and printing those out, but one verse today of O Zion Haste, our theme for the fall stewardship campaign. Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Have mercy on us, Lord.
And hear us on the prayer. We go to hear your living word. It saves us from despair. Have mercy on us,
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Sovereign God, you have created us to live in loving community with one another. Form us for life that is faithful and steadfast, and teach us to trust like little children, that we may reflect the image of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. We're ready for Sandy Sanders and our first Stewardship Temple Talk under that theme of O Zion Haste. And Sandy serves on the Stewardship Committee as well.
Well, my first line is a repeat. My name is Sandy Sanders. I am here today both as a longtime member of our congregation and also as a member of the Board of Directors of the Open Door Food Pantry. The Open Door Food Pantry, located just south of here on Front Street, has been providing emergency food to the residents of Butler County since 1981. Following the disruption by the pandemic, the people needing food from the pantry has steadily grown such that today we are serving approximately 300 individuals per week. The ability of the pantry to continue its service to the hungry of Hamilton and Butler County is possible through the generosity and support of community members and organizations such as Zion Lutheran Church and our congregation. Zion's congregational ministries have supported the pantry through monetary and in-kind donations, such as collecting plastic garbage bags or grocery bags for use at the pantry. Over the years, individual members of Zion have provided their time and talent to the pantry by serving on the pantry board and its committees. These individuals include Dave Shule, Lori Rehm, Bill Carpenter, Eric Wittig, Joannette Coe, and myself. In addition, for many years, Zion has offered its sanctuary here for the presentation of its spiritual music concert fundraiser. As you can see, Zion has been a longtime supporter of the pantry in many ways. Now I'd like to share with you a personal experience I had at the pantry some 5 or 6 years ago. It was a Saturday morning, and I was working at the pantry by myself, cleaning up. We were closed, and a fellow walked in the door and said, "Can I have some food?" My immediate response was, "Well, we're closed, and the computers are shut down, so I can't register, but we'll be open 9 o'clock Monday morning." Well, he looked at me and said, "I'm hungry, and I got no place to go for a meal." Well, I immediately changed my response, helped him get some food, and sent him on his way. And he was very appreciative, and I was happy that I was able to help someone in need. However, later that day, I got to thinking, there has never been a day in my life that I did not know where my next meal was going to come from. And here I had just faced an individual who did not know where his next meal was going to come from. Food insecurity is a nice general term, but when I came personally face to face with the need, it became very real and very personal. Today, the pantry continues to be a go-to place for hungry, challenged residents of Butler County, thanks in part to the existence of Zion Lutheran Church and its compassionate ministry and members. Through our response to the O Zion Haste Stewardship Campaign, we, the members of Zion, have the opportunity to sustain our church body through the pledges of our treasures, and to participate in our church's ministries through the contributions of our personal time and talent. As our stewardship campaign unfolds over the next 6 weeks, I encourage you to consider how you can share with our challenged neighbors the gifts that have been given to us by our God.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The first lesson is from Genesis 2, 18 to 24. The Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." So out of the ground, the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living thing, that was its name. The man gave names to all cattle and to the birds of the air and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. And then he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This is at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of a man this one was taken. Therefore a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We will now read responsively Psalm 8. O Lord our God,
how majestic is your name in all the earth.
You, whose glory is chanted above the heavens, out of the mouths of infants and children. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers,
the moon and the stars you have set in your forces,
what are mere mortals that you should be mindful of them?
Human beings that you should care for them.
Yet you have made them less, little less than divine. You have made them rule over the works of your hands. All flocks and cattle,
even the wild beasts of the field,
the birds of the air, the fish of the sea,
and whatever passes along the paths of the sea.
O Lord, our Lord,
how majestic is your name in all the earth.
The second lesson is from Hebrews 1. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and varied ways by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by a Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also created the worlds. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being, and he sustains all things by his powerful word. When he made purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, having become as much superior to angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. Now, God did not subject the coming world about which we are speaking to angels, but someone has testified somewhere, "What are human beings that you are mindful of them, or mortals that you care for them? You made them for a little lower than the angels. You have crowned them with glory and honor, subjecting all things under their feet. Now, in subjecting all things to them, God left nothing outside their control. As it is, we do not yet see everything in subjection to them, but we do see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, now crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. It was fitting that God, for whom through all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, should make the pioneer of their salvation perfect through sufferings. For the one who sanctifies and those who are sanctified all have one Father. For this reason, Jesus is not ashamed to call them brothers and sisters, saying, 'I will proclaim your name to my brothers and sisters. In the midst of the congregation, I will praise you.'" Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, Lord and Savior. Oh, alleluia.
Gospel according to St. Mark, the 10th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Some Pharisees came, and to test Jesus they asked, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife?" He answered them, "What did Moses command you?" They said, "Moses allowed a man to write a certificate of dismissal and to divorce her." But Jesus said to them, "Because of your hardness of heart, he wrote this commandment for you. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." Then in the house, the disciples asked him again about this matter. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." People were bringing little children to him in order that he might touch them. And the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, let the little children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it. And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and bless them. The Holy Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
As we sing the doxology with the children, please join me up here on the steps. Have pastor's two grandsons here with us today. Let's welcome them. As you were coming up the aisle, did you happen to look at any of our windows? And can anybody find what window has Jesus welcoming the little children? You in the congregation, show us which window it is. I believe we have one, don't we? Ah, it's over there. The last one all the way in the back? Oh, no, that second one. When you go back to your seats, look at that window. That is exactly what Jesus did in our gospel reading today. He told his disciples, "You are wrong. Do not stop the little children. Let them come to me." And as you can see, they sat on his lap, and he hugged them, he touched them, he loved them, and he gave them his blessing. And he told us that the little children are where our kingdom lies. We have to have faith like a little child to get to God's kingdom. And you know, God's kingdom is special for each and every one of you. So that is a wonderful window that we have here in our sanctuary. Every time I look at that window, I feel real good. Because even though I stand before you as an old lady, I am still a child of God, and that's how Jesus would welcome me as well. And isn't that something to say hallelujah about? Would you pray with me? Heavenly Father, thank you so much for these little children. They are truly our future, and they are what life is all about. Protect them in their comings and their goings. Thank God that they have people, they have parents and grandparents and aunts and uncles who bring them here to church to learn your word. In Jesus' name we pray and give our thanks. And all God's children say, amen. Amen. Come on, let's shout that. Amen. Good deal. Now, over here are your coloring pages. Ooh. Hand them out, Julia. Thank you. What did you remember about Vicar Patty's sermon? She gave me a coloring page. Okay, you may go back to your seats and check out that window as you go, please. Oh, you left a little creature. There's a little creature on the step. Okay, I guess. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. I hope Carolyn Supine is listening. She loves a sermon opened that way. And that is actually the King James Version of Psalm 19, verse 14. And I use that version because it has the word strength. Aaron and I were reminiscing on Sunday about the time when we did not have a pastor in our church. And she and Robin and I were your worship leaders. And we would make a schedule of who would lead worship when, on what Sunday. And invariably, every time it was Erin's turn to lead worship, the scripture that she had to do her sermon on was the most difficult one we had had that month. And I felt her angst. And I almost wanted to call her and say, would you like to be guest speaker this week? Because we have, and she's shaking her head no. We have a difficult scripture to talk about. So I read that particular version of Psalm 19 because I need the strength to make it through this sermon. So I needed to ask for strength, as we all do, in our broken world. But let's have a little bit of humor first. That first reading where it talks about God taking a rib from the man and making the woman, that made me chuckle. Because a woman walked into her kitchen one day and her young son is lying on the floor, sort of holding his side. And she said, Tommy, what's wrong with you? He says, oh, man, it hurts. I think I'm losing a rib. I must be giving birth to a wife. So I had my humor thinking about that joke while Robin read that lesson. And now I have to go into the hard stuff. Human relationships are hard. Enough said. Can I stop there? I don't think so. The Pharisees in our gospel reading once again posed a question to Jesus, attempting to trip him up and get him into trouble. Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife? And once again, Jesus quoted Old Testament law. Verse 9 says, therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. Here again, I like King James. What therefore God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Those are the words that were said at my wedding. Were they said at yours? Those are wedding words, yes? We humans are broken. And it stands to reason that at times our relationships will show that brokenness. And our relationships might break. Our Lutheran theology encourages us to give each other the same grace that God gives to us. Giving grace in a relationship can be something as simple as compromising. Although that sometimes can be hard, can it? Because we want what we want. One show of grace can be understanding a person's feelings, trying to walk a mile in their shoes. And the biggest form, I think, of giving grace is forgiveness. Good relationships are based on trust. But what happens when that trust is broken? And in a marriage, if you can't get that trust back, is the marriage over? Is forgiveness possible when trust is broken? No matter how much grace we want to give? Can it be repaired? There is no good time for divorce, but sometimes there is a necessary time. Divorce is not the intended outcome of marriage. We don't go into marriage thinking about divorcing. And the mere word divorce can elicit pain. Jesus was quoting law to the Pharisees. But Jesus was part man, and he understood our relationships. He showed us several times in the Bible that caring for people and the welfare of people was more important than the law. For instance, when he healed the man's hand on the Sabbath, and the Jewish leaders all got bent out of shape about it because he was working on the Sabbath. And the Sabbath when Jesus and his disciples were walking through the field of grain, and they were picking off the grain and eating it on the Sabbath. They were hungry. That was more important than the law. It's all about people. Caring and loving people. I always refer you to your bulletin, and you probably get sick of it. But in your bulletin is an article that's entitled Relationships Over Rules. And in that article, it reminded me how we treat each other matters to God. The article goes on to say, Jesus points to Genesis where God sets the intention for relationships to be filled with love, respect, and accountability. What happens in a marriage when those things no longer exist? I believe in this scripture, what Jesus is telling us is that we should not enter into divorce lightly. It should not be a whim. We should seek and go down every avenue we possibly can for reconciliation before making the decision to divorce. Divorce is a death. It's the death of a marriage. And there will be mourning. God does not intend for us to be happy, nor does he intend for us to be in unsafe relationships. This text could be viewed as encouragement to remain in a toxic relationship. I do not feel that is what Jesus is telling you. God wants you safe and happy. My entire childhood was spent living under the threat of my parents' impending divorce, which then happened a year after I was married. Some people are just better off not being together. Divorce can lead to renewed life for the two individuals once they separate. It can lead to renewed life for their children. People who are contemplating divorce, I hope, are in community like we are here, where they have trusted people in their community that they can talk to. You are not alone. God has never broken trust with us. He is always with you. Through all the trials and trauma of divorce, God is present. God is with you. So seek out his love and guidance during those troubled and difficult times of your life. God wants us in community, trusting and loving each other. As the ELCA says, we are stronger and better together. Let's mention the children. Divorce is confusing to us adults. Can you imagine what it does to a child? Many times children will blame themselves for the divorce. If only I was better. If only I didn't make daddy upset. If only I listened to mommy. Children need to remember that the inability of their parents to get along in their relationship is not their responsibility. It is their parents' responsibility to navigate their life in their relationship. in a healthy manner. Remember, God is with you. He wants you to be happy and safe. Now, this story, the beginning was hard to talk about. The next half is happier. Mark then goes and talks about the children coming and sitting on Jesus' lap and getting his love and getting his blessings. But the way one story follows the other, it almost made me think, were the women and children on the periphery of this preaching? And were those children coming to Jesus because they were children of divorce and all the angst that goes with that? Just the way those two stories were linked. And I hope that's so, because those children needed Jesus. And when I said to the children standing before you as an old lady, and I look at that window, and I know that I can still go to Jesus. And what I see in those little children is I see the little Patty May going to receive blessings from Jesus. In your bulletin cover, if you read that article, it expresses these things I've shared with you much better than I can. And what I would like to do today, those of you that got God pause this morning, you may not have been able to read it yet. I was really early. It got to you earlier today. But I'm going to read what they said in God pause. And the Holy Spirit works in magnificent ways, because our sermon hymn is Blessed Be the Tide That Binds. And the person who wrote God Pause for today, that's what they talked about. So it came very timely to me. And what the author says is, our devotions have pondered God's caring love in human relationships. This hymn speaks of pouring out in ardent prayer our fears, our hopes, our comforts, and our cares. God cares about each and every part of our lives, the relationships we have with one another. Living on this earth in human community, there are bound to come times that fill us with shame, regret, and fear. The beauty of being in community with others is that we can share our mutual woes, our mutual burdens bear, and often for each other flows the sympathizing tear. Despite what holds us back, preventing us from living full lives, hope remains. From sorrow, toil, and pain, and sin, we shall be free, and perfect love and friendship reign through all eternity. My ministry has confirmed that there is nothing in our lives which is hidden from God. Jesus, our Savior, has come to deliver us from what ails us, free our relationships from the shackles of sin, and bring us into a time of joy with each other. Oh God, thank you for the gift of human relationships. Help us to see that we are not stuck forever in poor ways of being together. Thank you for redeeming even us. And all God's children say, Amen. All right, so now we will sing this hymn that I just told you about. Please stand.
Children may want to come to the front row.
Ah, Pastor just said, good idea. Children, may you come to the front row if you would like to see.
Right here?
Okay. Your other grandson doesn't want?
I guess he's staying for
it. Okay, stay with Grandma. Okay. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the baptized in the one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. Who presents Robert William Zorno for baptism?
I present Robert William Zorno for baptism.
Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, Bobby, do you desire to be baptized into Christ? Sponsors, do you promise to nurture Robert in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help him live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church?
I do.
People of God, do you promise to support Robert and pray for him in his new life in Christ?
We do.
Will the congregation please stand? Harry and Terry and Robin and Bobby, I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God?
I renounce them.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in God the Father,
the Son of the Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family, and through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death and raise us up to live in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. Robert William Zorno, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may use that to wipe your head. Blessed be God, the source
of all life, the word of salvation, the spirit of mercy.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give your daughters and sons new birth. Cleanse them from sin and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Robert with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
Robert William Zorno, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever.
Amen.
Michael?
Wipe your hand. Good.
You would light that from the baptismal candle. Whoops. Oh, there it comes.
You should have probably lighted it before.
Upside down. If you want to present it, Bobby.
Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will have the light of life. Will you please stand?
Let us welcome the newly baptized Robert William Zorno.
We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's welcome Bobby. Good deal. Okay.
There's the box for it. Bobby, there's a baptismal shell there.
And here are your certificates.
And make sure to greet those who we identified as visitors
Thank you, Bobby's family as well. Thank you. You are so welcome.
Good morning. God's peace be with you. Glad to see you. God's peace. We can bring communion to you. Okay. God's peace. God's peace. Thank you. God's peace. God's peace be with you. God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. You have a visitor behind you to make sure to greet Esther. Okay. Okay. God's peace be with you. God's peace. God's peace. Glad you came up. God's peace.
We turn to God in prayer. Challenged by God's word in Christ, let us pray for the church, the world, and the whole creation. God of our ancestors, we give thanks for the church in all times. This week we lift up All Saints Lutheran Church in Cincinnati and St. Joseph Catholic Church here in Hamilton. May we listen for the prophets of this age who bear messages that stir the church toward renewal and justice. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Restoring Lord, grant healing and wholeness to those who are sick and suffering, especially Heidi, Peg, Barbara, Brian, Kathy, Carol, Barb, Sarah, Sherry, Shirley, Sean, Dawn, Kathy, Gail, Dave, John, Cash. Especially today we lift up Phil and Carol Flommer. And we lift before you the family of Dave Bielou, as well as those we hold silently on our hearts, praying for doctors, nurses, and healthcare workers who provide care. And we lift up also before you today, Doug Edwards. Work through medical professionals to diagnose, ease pain, and give life to all who seek their wisdom and experience. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Unifying God, in a world so wired and interconnected, our anxious hearts are pummeled by an endless barrage of troubling news. We are daily aware of more grief, O Lord, than we can rightly consider, of more hostility, hatred, horror, and injustice. But you are not disquieted by news of cruelty. You are neither anxious nor overwhelmed. You carry the full weight of suffering of the world all the way to the cross. You carry it still. When the cacophony unsettles us, remind us that you are present with us. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Guard us from shutting down our empathy or walling off our hearts. Move each of us to respond with compassion, to be expressions of your presence that is already there. Bless the work of Lutheran Disaster Response as they serve in the areas so damaged and hit so hard by Hurricane Helene. Give us wisdom in the face of troubling news reports. Give us discernment to know when to act, when to speak out, when to place our anxiety at your feet, and when to pray that your kingdom of peace be present within our world. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in the saving grace you freely give, both now and forever.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, source of every gift of your creation. By these gifts and with our lives, help us to serve one another and all in need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who on this first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. And our table and our food. You created a world in which all might be satisfied by your abundance. You dined with Abraham and Sarah, promising them life, and fed your people Israel with manna from heaven. You sent your son to eat with sinners and to become food for the world. The night in which he was betrayed, Jesus our Lord took bread from the Passover meal. He gave thanks for it, broke it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this and eat. This is my body broken for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Also, after the supper, he took the cup of wine, and after giving thanks, he gave it for all of them to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it, for the remembrance of me." By your Spirit, nurture and sustain us with this meal. Strengthen us to serve all in hunger and want. And by this bread and cup, make of us the body of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen." Jesus welcomes you to this table. Come, here is your God. Zion Lutheran practices Eucharistic hospitality. Communing members of all other Christian fellowships are invited to share in this meal of grace today. You may be seated. Life come down from heaven for you. The body of Christ given for you, Sonia. Patty, the bread of heaven come down for you. The blood of Christ was given and shed for you. His blood was poured out for you. The blood of Christ given and shed for you.
is staying seated, so we're going to bring communion to her.
Life come down from heaven for you.
Take this and eat the body of Christ broken for you. Bread of heaven, it is for you. Join the body of Christ broken for you.
The bread of heaven has come down for you, Jason.
Sandy, the body of Christ broken for you.
Take this and eat the bread of life from heaven for you.
The body of Christ broken for you.
Anna, the body of Christ broken for you.
Jacob, Jesus our Lord, took young children in his arms and he blessed them.
Doug, the body of Christ broken for you.
Mark, the bread of heaven has come down for you.
Take this and eat the body of Christ broken for you, Joe.
Take this and eat the bread of life come down from heaven. It is for you. And see the body of Christ broken for you. Save the bread of heaven for you. The body of Christ broken for you. This is the bread of life from heaven for you. The body of Christ was broken for you. Sandy, the bread of heaven for you. The body of Christ broken for you, Julie.
Jesus said to the disciples, "Let the children come to me and do not forbid them, for to such as these belongs the kingdom of heaven."
The body of Christ broken for you.
Laura, the bread of heaven given for you.
Richard, the body of Christ broken for you.
Take this and eat the bread of life come down from heaven for you.
Take the body of Christ broken for you.
Mike, the bread of heaven for you.
Fritz, the body of Christ for you.
Lee, the bread of heaven for you.
Take it. Christ broken for you.
Ed, the body of Christ broken for you.
Leanne, the bread of heaven given for you.
May the body of Christ broken for you.
All of the bread of heaven given for you.
The body of Christ broken for you.
Take this and eat the bread of heaven given for you. Kathy, this is the bread of life come down from heaven for you. Take and eat. Bread of heaven was given for you. Now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen. Amen.
God, you have welcomed us to this meal and fed us with dignity at your table. Send us now to welcome others and be at peace with one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God Almighty, God most merciful, bless you, keep you, and give you peace.
Amen. Amen.
Let's go out singing, "All creatures worship God most high."
Oh,
I'd like to say congratulations to Bobby, and thank you to everyone who helped with worship service this morning. Go in peace, follow Jesus, reaching out with God's love.